Good evening, and welcome. Welcome to the Belfast Central School's new auditorium. For many of you, it's probably the first time that you've seen it. I did not see the old auditorium, but this auditorium is state-of-the-art. Great lights, great sound. So welcome to our new auditorium. Before we begin the ceremony in just a few short minutes, I do have to take care of some housekeeping items. Per New York State and CDC guidelines, masks must be worn if you have not received the COVID vaccine. Masks may be removed while you are seated. We will be using the honor system for compliance. If the fire alarm should sound, we will exit the building through the doors to my left, your right, and head to the King Street sidewalk. Please do not leave your seat during the ceremony. The district has arranged for pictures to be taken. A recording of the ceremony will be available to the public next week. And one last housekeeping item. At the end of the ceremony, there will be a reception line outside on the front lawn, again, to my left, your right, on the King Street side of the building. Thank you. Now I'd like to recognize a few people that without them, this whole ceremony would not be possible. First, to our maintenance staff for working extra hard to make the auditorium and the building ready for the ceremony. So Mr. Jim Schneider, thank you to you and your crew. Mr. Rob Morgan, thank you for the countless hours of working on the technical side of things, preparing the live stream video, the recording, preparing the iPads for the seniors to take home, and many, many other technical things I don't understand, but you take care of them. Thank you. I'd also like to thank Ms. Jasmine Shepherd and Mr. Josh Hazelton for working the PA system, the microphones, charge batteries, operating the video screen, the mixing the sound, the lights. Thank you. I'd like to thank Ms. Catherine Schwebka. Thank you for preparing the slideshow for the presentation that you will see in one short minute. To Mrs. Kim Stack, Mr. J.D. Struckman, thank you for rehearsing with our senior musicians who will be performing for you shortly. Ms. Teresa Heaney, thank you for putting together the program for tonight's ceremony. And Mrs. Tina Lingenfelter and Michelle Kalani, thank you for serving as the class advisors for the countless hours that you have invested into these students. Thank you. Can we give them a round of applause, please? Now, at this time, I would like to welcome our Board of Education, our Superintendent, Dr. Wendy Butler, teachers, staff, parents, grandparents, friends, and loved ones. But especially, I'd like to welcome our graduates of the class of 2021. This year, once again, has been a year that we've never seen before. We started this year with in-person school on Tuesday and Thursday for some students, Wednesday and Fridays for other students. And the days that they weren't here, they were doing remote learning. Then we shifted gears. We had some students here on Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, others here Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Still others just doing Tuesday, Thursday, others doing Wednesday, Friday. And then on those off days, continuing with the remote. Then we changed it again from Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Some kids were 5 days a week. Those days they weren't here, there was still a remote. Then finally, we got the okay to be here 5 days a week. Yes, it was as confusing for us as it was for you and your students. But parents, I cannot thank you enough for your partnership through this difficult year. I thank you so much, parents, for being flexible and for trusting us that we are providing the best education that we can under these difficult circumstances. With your support and partnership, we made this crazy year a success, and we are here to celebrate that success. So thank you. So at this time, yes, please. Now at this time, may I shift your attention to the screen for a slideshow presentation.
I've heard it said, people into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most to grow if we let them, and we help them in return.
Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you.
Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better?
But because I knew you,
I have been changed for good. It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part, so much of me is made from what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart.
And now whatever way this story ends,
I know you have rewritten mine by being my friend. Like a ship blown from its mooring by a wind off the sea, like a seed dropped by a scud in a distant world. Who can say if I've been changed for the better?
But because I knew you, because I knew you,
I have been changed for good. And just to clear the air, I ask forgiveness for the things I've done you blame me for. But then I guess we know there's blame to share, and none of it seems to matter anymore. Like a comet,
like a ship alone
as it passes the sun,
by a wind off the sea,
like a stream that meets a border, say if I've been changed for the better.
I do believe I have been changed for the better.
And
because I knew you,
because I knew you,
because I knew you,
I have been changed.
The days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted, till your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. that you never forget all the ones who love you in the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take, but more than anything. Yeah, more than anything. My wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want it to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah,
into our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn, and we are led to those who help us most to grow if we let them, and we help them in return.
Well, I don't know if I
Salute begin. I pledge allegiance
Our guest speaker needs no introduction for most of us. We were in second grade when he came to BCS, and he was our principal until the middle of last year. He watched us grow and was always there for us. And even on the rare occasions when we got in trouble, we always knew he cared. He watched us play sports, watched our concerts and plays, traveled with us to Washington, D.C., and was a constant in our lives at BCS. We miss you and are honored to have you as our guest speaker, Mr. Oach.
Wow, thanks, Cam. Welcome, guests, friends, faculty and staff, families, and most importantly, graduates. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to be a part of your education, and today, your graduation ceremony. I'm not sure if you asked me here because you thought this would be a short talk, or because you missed me. Believe it or not, I have missed you. Well, at least most of you. Before you officially graduate, I'm going to challenge you to do a few things today. First, let's reflect on your time as a student. I challenge you to forget about all the homework, quizzes, tests, and any other problems that you faced along the way. Your time and energy are best spent on positive things that you experienced as a student. Focus on your time outside the classroom, things that you did where you were learning but didn't even know you were learning. Who can forget? Mini society? Anybody have a jingle? Camp Duffield? The eighth grade, Gettysburg, D.C. trip, plays, concerts, soccer and basketball games, the proms, and finally your senior trip. My hope is that these were activities that you will remember and hopefully look back on with fond memories. I challenge you to take what you learned while engaged in these activities and use the skills you have learned, as skills such as effectively interacting with others, learning to room with someone that's not as neat as you are, negotiating the best price for that brownie, working together to achieve a common goal, a win on the field, or an outstanding production on the stage. Put those skills to use, and I know you will, and you will be a successful adult. I challenge you to reflect on the many opportunities that you had to develop relationships with the faculty and staff here. And you learned much more than just the topic or the objective for the day. Just think. Most of you had the opportunity to experience Mrs. Marsh's patience and dedication during your seventh grade sewing unit. How many times did you have to rip out the pincushion before it passed her test? Think about it. Why was she so focused on you doing the task correctly? It wasn't really for the passing grade. It was to help you to develop the stamina and dedication that you needed to complete the job you were working on, but later on, the jobs and tasks that would come before you. How about all the times when you talked sports with Mrs. Burr? How many times did she use stats from sports to help you better understand percentages? And what about her misguided devotion to the Yankees? Seriously, what is their payroll in real life math? Did you get to make paper airplanes with Ms. Brace this year in economics? If you did, do you remember why you were doing that? No, it wasn't just about assembly lines and productivity. It was about learning to work together more efficiently. And what about Mr. Heaney's knowledge and interesting tidbits of U.S. history? You were certain they were going to be on the test, but they weren't. He shared them with you so that you could learn to enjoy and love history and learn from it. Because if we don't learn from history and the mistakes of the past, we are destined to repeat them. And you might be able to use them on Jeopardy. Realistically, I think we could go on and talk about all of your teachers. I'm sure that you all learned something other than the math lesson or how to diagram a sentence from your teachers. I challenge you to be willing to be true to yourself and accept whatever gifts and talents you have and focus on your time and energy of those talents. Even if you don't use those skills in your future careers, they are important in helping you to be you. While you were a student, you had many opportunities to develop your interests through extracurricular activities and elective classes, sports, music, art, cooking, technology. Again, we could go on and on. These classes allowed you to specialize and focus on your individual talents, areas of interest, and grow as an individual. Use these experiences and then turn them into a career or a hobby that you may enjoy as an adult. I challenge you to take what you have learned and face what comes next because you are ready. Even though some of you may not feel you are ready, you are prepared for the next phase of your life, whether it's college, the military, or directly to a job. No matter which path you have chosen, if you use your talents and what you have learned, you will find employment easily. Experts predict that there are going to be many, many jobs out there, and you'll have a chance to even change your career several times until you find what fits for you. I challenge you to find a job that you enjoy. I challenge you to find some way to give back to others. Volunteerism is at an all-time low. Volunteer for the SPCA, a local church, a volunteer fire department, any of the number of hospitals or food kitchens, helping your elderly neighbor. The possibilities are endless. My belief is that in volunteering in some way or another is much more rewarding than any career can be. I challenge you to give more than you take. Think about that. Give more than you take. Finally, I challenge you to never give up. Along with great opportunities will come great obstacles. Do not look at the obstacles negatively. Look at them as lessons along the way to achieving your goals. You can gain great strength, courage, and confidence through each failure if you choose to learn from it. When the task seems insurmountable, focus on the next step ahead instead of the end game. When you hit those roadblocks, and no matter what your plans are, you will hit roadblocks, take a breath and ask yourself, where am I supposed to be and what am I supposed to be doing? Some of you know what I mean by that. It is in that time of reflection that you will find the clarity that you need to move forward. I look forward to hearing about all the great things that I know you will do as you navigate life. Congratulations for all that you have accomplished so far. Congratulations for all that you will do. I challenge all of you to do your best. And again, thank you for letting me be a part of your story.
distance and style that stands for a while. Heaven can wait, we're only watching the skies, hoping for the best but expecting the worst. Are you gonna drop the bomb or not? Let us die young or let us live forever. We don't have the power, but we'll never say never. Sitting in a sandpit, life is a short trip, the music's for the sad man. Can you imagine when this race is won? Turn our golden faces into the sun, praising our leaders, we're getting in tune. The music's played by the madman. Forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really wanna live forever, 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 forever young? I wanna be forever young. Do you really wanna live forever?
One, two, one, two, three, four.
If you ever find yourself stuck in the middle of the sea, I'll sail the world to find you. If you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light. Find out what we're made of when we are called to help our friends in need. You can count on me, like one, two, three, I'll be there. And I know when I need it, I can count on you, like
wonderful performance. Thank you. At this time, I have the pleasure of introducing to you the salutatorian for Belfast Central School, class of 2021. This young lady is remarkable. She was very active in our athletic program, participating in soccer, basketball, and softball, which she was the captain of each of those teams for 3 years. She was also voted the MVP of the softball team. She has served as president of the National Honor Society, treasurer of student council, and was a class president for 4 years. She's actively involved in the musical and drama club productions, having leading and supporting roles. She was selected to numerous all counties, area, state for both band and choir, and selected to the conference all state choir. She has a beautiful voice. I hope you sing every day. I could listen to you all the time. She also serves an altar server for the St. Patrick Roman Catholic Church and volunteers within the community. And in her spare time, she has worked at the Coffee Plus Cafe and at Cuba Hospital. Ladies and gentlemen, the salutatorian for the Belfast Central School class of 2021 is Miss Emma Sullivan.
Here we are, the bittersweet fulfillment of outgrowing this normal and closed atmosphere we've been a part of for 14 years. I'm not sure where to start, so I'll start by saying thank you. Thank you means more in this sense than just two words used to express gratitude. This thank you goes beyond the surface to deeply connect with my innermost being. First, thank you to the community, administrators, and the Board of Education. Thank you for all the time that is put into the school and the opportunities for the students. Growing up in this town, I felt safe and supported by the members inside and outside of the school. Second, thank you to the teachers and coaches that have helped me along the way. Each of the adult role model figures have shaped my character, whether it was my classroom work ethic or participating on the field or court. I was always encouraged to reach my full potential, and I am genuinely grateful for the discipline while receiving no special treatment during my time at Belfast. This year, I was involved in the new Visions Health Professions program, which challenged my academic ability to a potential it had never been before. I would personally like to thank my teacher, Mrs. Andrea Lasnik, for preparing me for reality, bringing energy into the classroom, and encouraging me to want to learn more every day. She has shaped my self-image significantly this year, and I cannot thank her enough for all she has done. Finally, a thank you to my parents, my biggest supporters, my personal support system, and the ones who always keep pushing me further. No matter what hardship, stress, or injury I was faced with, my head was always lifted a little higher each day. They have never doubted my potential, have always treated me fairly, and have poured their hearts into making sure the biggest achievement I had was a smile on my face. This year, I began to reflect on my time at Belfast. Music has always been a positive influence in my life. When I was around the age of 9 or 10, I went to see my first musical performed at school and knew in that very moment I wanted to be just like the student actors on that very stage. And that is just what I did. Middle school was when I first became involved with the music department at Belfast. Starting solo fest, all counties, band and choir, plays and musicals, I've unlocked a part of me that was meant to be. Even though I'm not super outgoing on stage, I have become more comfortable, and that has come from the teachers and the time that was put into the music department. On the other hand, I'm also grateful to have been part of the sports teams at Belfast. From the time my grandfather was a teacher and coach to my father now filling his role, my family has had ties to the athletic community for decades. Playing three sports, managing my involvement with music and theater, and having time for schoolwork has not been an easy challenge by any means. Each coach has been understanding and willing to compromise with my other events, which I'm truly grateful for. I have been held to high standards from each coach, and they have made me enjoy the game even more, no matter what sport was being played. From being on a team, I have developed stronger communication skills, leadership ability, friendships, and an understanding of the importance of teamwork in everyday situations. Looking back on my time at Belfast, I've learned many important lessons that I will carry with me throughout life. For all of the younger students, never be afraid to take the leap into trying something new. Play a sport, join a musical, participate in clubs, but always remember who you are and how you want to express yourself. High school is the place where new experiences occur and how you can cultivate a well-established image of yourself. Work hard in all that you do. Do not be afraid of asking for help. And most of all, have fun. To my classmates, thank you for the memories I will never forget, the laughs until my sides hurt, and the tears we wiped off each other's faces. You have shown me what friendships look like, and I am grateful to have grown up with all of you over these 14 years. Each one of you will go on to do amazing things in whatever it is you plan on doing. My words of advice is to live in the moment while keeping an eye on the future. Life is short, unexpected, and challenging, yet beautiful. Never be afraid of failure, never be afraid to grow, and always, always stay humble. I would like to end with a quote by Ed Helms. He states, "Don't be afraid of fear, because it sharpens you, challenges you, it makes you stronger. And when you run away from fear, you also run away from the opportunity to be your best possible self." Life will always give you challenges, whether it may be people in power trying to lower or not acknowledge your ability, or your own personal hardships. It will only make you stronger in the end. As we begin to move forward with our lives, always remember to persevere through life with your head high and a smile on your face. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you, Emma. At this time, I'm going to introduce to you the valedictorian for the class of 2021 of Belfast Central School. This young lady is a standout student here at Belfast. She is very active in the music department as well as the drama club. She has participated in choir, wind ensemble, and jazz band. She has been selected to all county and area all-state festivals of both choir and band. You just heard her play and sing guitar. She did not even know how to play guitar when school started in September. And she's now strumming and singing as if she's done it for years. And I hope she strums and sings every single day. Keep jamming. She has had leading and supporting roles in school plays and musicals. She is active in local and community theater and has performed shows in the Town Theater of Short Track, Valley Theater, and the Olean Theater Workshop, which I believe I heard that she started acting there in first grade. She's been doing it a long time. She was one of 32 students selected across New York State to participate in the New York State Summer School of the Arts for Theater during her sophomore year. She was then elected to return for an advanced program in 2020. But of course, due to COVID, she wasn't allowed to go, but she did get to participate online. She has also participated in the American Legion Oratorical Competition, which she has advanced through the local levels all the way through the district and regional levels. She was the winner of the Malero Writing Competition and participates in the Allegheny County History Awareness Week. She also, in her downtime, works for Dunkin' Donuts. Ladies and gentlemen, the valedictorian of the Belfast Central School class of 2021 is Miss Aiden Heaney.
Board of Education, administration, faculty, and family, thank you for bearing witness to this milestone. Friends, classmates, graduates, we have finally reached that day where we can no longer call ourselves students of Belfast Central School. For many of us, this fact may be almost impossible to fathom. I know for myself, BCS has always been a home, and the thought of what lies ahead without it is nebulous and abstract. Instead of facing that head on, I've found myself recently succumbing to waves of nostalgia. I've taken some time to thumb through old yearbooks in an attempt to put the past 14 years and the previous generations into perspective. And I've been able to send myself spiraling back into the beginning of our educational careers. Allow me to take you back in time to 2007. We were in the last year of the presidency of George W. Bush. The first generation of iPhone was released. The only Taylor Swift album in existence was debut, and The Sopranos aired its final season. Our world has clearly evolved and grown along with us in the past decade and a half, yet the presence of this institution has been a constant. a strong floor at our feet and roof over our heads, four infallible walls which allowed us a window to the world, largely protected from its dangers, and most powerfully, a preview of coming attractions. I speak for my class when I say that attending BCS has been the most formative, central, and enduring experience of our lives. So you can imagine the words to pay it tribute properly are impossibly elusive. But what else are we here to do but pay tribute to our time? A valedictory address is one of those institutional traditions of a ceremony focused on community. And so, in the spirit of community, come I to try and speak generally on an experience that will be remembered by each of us in disparate shades of not just color, but emotion and experience. What does it mean to have a home? Are the connections we forge to place and time based on anything other than circumstance, a pure coincidence of fate? Or are they deeper, more connected bonds forged by our active participation in life? The idea of a home, a stable, supportive ground to stand on, is so ingrained in the fabric of our struggle that I firmly believe the entire trajectory of a life is tracked in pursuit of it. Think of all the stories you have consumed, be they steeped in fiction or truer than life. Generally, the stories we tell ourselves about each other concern precisely this objective. Most wars are fought in the pursuit of some kind of home for a people. Most legends result from the search for an identity. The notion of looking for some kind of home is central to the most powerful fiction and most gripping of personal tales. We are each searching for a cause, a location, or a person to pin the weight of our hopes and dreams to and call ourselves settled. For many of us, however, this critical identity has been laid easily before us. We each have been randomly placed here, scattered like seeds in the wind. But because of the plentiful opportunities for growth and fortified community surrounding us, we have been able to emerge with strength. We have each needed to feel out our individual relationship with this home we have been given and find a way to utilize its resources to grow into the best version of ourselves. Some of us saw the lights on the athletic field shining overhead and planted ourselves firmly below them, while others found they grew best under spotlights or in the glow of a computer screen, while more still saw that they were best able to rise when their roots were intertwined with those of others. Because of this institution's support of student involvement, many of us have come by opportunities for growth and self-realization from various sources and have matured into vast, expansive organisms that take up the whole of the ground beneath us and shimmer in unique shades that come only from openness. While others still have been lucky enough to find the specific path that pertains to their quest toward home and have emerged exquisitely and intricately detailed reflections of passion imprinted with intensity. It is one of the pros of a small school that I am able to stand here before you as a representative of my class and be intimately aware of what makes each and every one of them unique and essential to this community. I think of how involved each of us has been in making the world around us a better place, and how each of our successes in our personal endeavors has made good on that goal. I speak for all of us when I say that I have had opportunities here to lead and to learn that would have been totally inaccessible had I been planted anywhere else. And it is because of those opportunities that I have grown into a being ready to move through the world with confidence. However, class of 2021, I pose you this question. What are we to do now that we have been uprooted? Right now, in this moment, a seismic shift is occurring, a shift that will impact every aspect of the rest of our lives. The ages of 17 and 18 have always filled me with a kind of mortal dread. How does it seem correct that we are at the age where we must begin to turn the gears that wheel us along our road to home? I can still feel the shadows and spirits of the helpless, clueless child I once was clinging to my person, and I feel much closer to that specter than the far-off holographic vision of an undefined future that glares at me from the horizon. Yet, I feel that I am able to trust that infantile voice in the back of my head, not only because I know that she is at her core unfailingly honest, but because she was shaped and curated by the hands of a community that showed her the world laid out before her like a garden and encouraged her to pick the wildflowers she liked best and carry them with her for all time. I have plucked the vast garden in my backyard until my pockets have filled and the flowers flow from my hair as they fall from my hands. And now it is time to do something with those stalks and stems, not let them wither away and be trampled on. It is time to plant them along the winding road, leading me to an eternity of nexts. So, class of 2021, I ask you now to take a moment to think of all the trinkets of truth that you have picked up during your time in this home, and notice how each of them have illuminated your journey toward the version of yourself you are becoming. Recognize how each of these has given you the skills necessary to blaze a trail through the wilderness towards the home that you seek. And remember that, while this home has been a singular temporal model for you to base your understanding of home on, the futures that await you should and will be as varied as the layers and complexities of your person. Our homes will be found in causes worth giving the whole of ourselves to, and in beliefs so infallible that they will govern our worldviews and stand strong despite external shifts and storms. Home will be in the commitment and passion we will imbue everything we touch with, and home will be in the connections we forge on the path towards success. For I have learned that it is impossible not to succeed if you back each of your steps with truth and dedication. Finally, I'd like to leave you with a quote from Stephen Sondheim's masterpiece, Sunday in the Park with George. Anything you do, let it come from you. Then it will be new. Give us more to see. Class of 2021, you have all the tools of self-knowledge within you to build the homes you so richly deserve. Now all I ask is that you stick to those beliefs and reference them often. For the only way to move forward is by following the map of where you have been. Stay true to the self that you have grown here, and I know that your success and fulfillment will be imminent. Thank you for all the lessons, memories, and affirmations. I look forward to witnessing the whole of our metamorphosis and looking back on these days from the back porch swings of the homes we are yet to create. Thank you.
...2021 graduate, Taylor Bissick. Taylor is the daughter of John and Cassandra Bissick. Taylor has made contributions to her school and community through participation on the cheerleading team and at the Belmont Career and Technical Center, where she has completed a two-year course of study in the field of early childhood education. Taylor has volunteered her time with local food giveaways and completed an internship with a Belfast pre-K class this year. Taylor receives a Belfast Alumni Scholarship, the Belfast School Related Personnel Scholarship, and the Belfast Area Betterment Association Jack Parker Scholarship. Next year, Taylor plans to attend Genesee Community College, majoring in early childhood education. Congratulations, Taylor. ...2021 graduate, Stephen Buchholz. Stephen is the son of Stephen and Jessica Buchholz. Stephen has made contributions to his school and community through his membership on the soccer, basketball, and baseball teams, and as a member of the Belfast Volunteer Fire Department. Stephen has completed a two-year course of study in natural resources and heavy equipment operations at the Belmont Career and Technical Center. Stephen receives an American Legion School Award. Next year, Stephen plans to attend Alfred State College, majoring in the Heavy Equipment Truck and Diesel Technician Program. Congratulations, Stephen. ...2021 graduate, Jason Drozdowski. Jason is the son of Jim Drozdowski and Renelle Enders. Jason has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the soccer, basketball, and baseball teams. Jason has completed a 2-year course of study in criminal justice at the Belmont Career and Technical Center. Next year, Jason plans to attend lineman school in Georgia. Congratulations, Jason. ...2021 graduate, Shannon Durigan. Shannon is the daughter of Scott and Sue Durigan. Shannon has made contributions to her school and community through participation on the soccer, basketball, and softball teams, and in a number of theatrical productions. Shannon has completed a 2-year course of study in cosmetology at the Belmont Career and Tech Center and has been employed at Three Bums in Houghton. Shannon receives a Theater Arts Award. Next year, Shannon plans to further her education online in a business-related field. Congratulations, Shannon.
...2021 graduate, Brianna Elliott. Bree is the daughter of Rick and Lisa Elliott. Bree has made contributions to her school and community through participation on the cheerleading team. Bree has completed a 2-year course of study in the field of cosmetology at the Belmont Career and Technical Center. Bree's plans for next year are undecided, but she will seek employment or make plans to further her education. Congratulations, Bree. ...2021 graduate, Nicholas Ellison. Nick is the son of Randy and Teresa Ellison. Nick has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the soccer, basketball, and baseball teams, and as a member of the National Honor Society. Nick has been employed at Harrington's. Nick receives a Belva Waite Scholarship, a Claire Emery Jr. Honorary Scholarship, a President's Award for Outstanding Academic Excellence, the Paul Vienna Alternate Scholarship, and an Amy Schaefer Garish Memorial Scholarship. Next year, Nick plans to attend Finger Lakes Community College, where he will major in kinesiology before transferring to a 4-year school for physical therapy. Congratulations, Nick. ...2021 graduate, Kale Francis. Kale is the son of Mike and Rita Francis. Kale has made contributions to his school and community through participation in numerous musical and theatrical productions. Kale has completed a 2-year course of study in criminal justice at the Belmont Career and Technical Center. Kale receives a Theater Arts Award, the Amanda Curcio Memorial Scholarship, and a Belva Waite Scholarship. Next year, Kale plans to attend Genesee Community College, majoring in fine arts. Congratulations, Kale. ...2021 graduate, Kylie Francis. Kylie is the daughter of Mike and Rita Francis. Kylie has made contributions to her school and community as a member of the National Honor Society and in numerous musical and theatrical productions. Kylie receives the Alfred University Scholars Award, a Theater Arts Award, the Ruth G. Tabor Memorial Scholarship, a President's Award for Outstanding Academic Excellence, and a Belva Waite Scholarship. Next year, Kylie plans to attend Alfred University, majoring in psychology. Congratulations, Kylie.
...2021 graduate, Christopher Fuller. Chris is the son of Mark Fuller and Daniel Rood. Chris has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the soccer, basketball, and baseball teams. He has been employed through the Allegheny County Youth Employment Program and at Previty's Wrecking. Chris has completed a two-year course of study at the Belmont CTE Center in auto technology and heavy equipment operations. Chris receives an American Legion School Award, the Robert W. Howden Post 1504 Scholarship, and a Triple C Award. Next year, Chris plans to attend Alfred State College, majoring in heavy equipment operations. Congratulations, Chris. ...2021 graduate, Colton Gaddy. Colton is the son of Josh and Carrie Burnell. Colton has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the basketball and track teams. Colton has completed a two-year course of study in natural resources at the Belmont Career and Tech Center. Next year, Colton plans to seek employment in the field of construction. Congratulations, Colton. ...2021 graduate, Nicholas Gugasello. Nick is the son of Patty Gugasello. Nick has completed a two-year course of study at the Belmont Career and Technical Center in the field of automotive technology. Next year, Nick plans to attend Jamestown Community College, majoring in welding technology. Congratulations, Nick. ...2021 graduate, Tia Hale. Tia is the daughter of Gerald and Christine Hale. Tia has made contributions to her school and community through involvement in the Allegheny County Saddle Dusters and as a volunteer at Creekside. Tia has completed a two-year course of study in media communications at the Belmont CTE Center, where she earns a Belmont CTE scholarship. Tia also receives a Belfast Lions Club scholarship and the Belfast Betterment Association Wilma Bedwell scholarship. Next year, Tia plans to attend Jamestown Community College, majoring in liberal arts. Congratulations, Tia.
...2021 graduate, Melvin Hamer. Melvin is the son of Scott Hamer and the grandson of Lucy Powers. Melvin has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the soccer, basketball, and track teams, as class treasurer, as a member of student council, and through employment at Oaks Pit Stop. Melvin's plans for next year are still undecided, but he plans to seek employment or continue his education. Congratulations, Melvin. ...2021 graduate, Devin Harriger. Devin is the son of Steve and Kristen Harriger. Devin has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the soccer and basketball teams and is a member of student council. Devin receives a NADA June Aumann Memorial Scholarship. Next year, Devin plans to attend Finger Lakes Community College, majoring in forest management. Congratulations, Devin. ...2021 graduate, Samantha Havens. Sam is the daughter of Chad and Deb Havens. Sam has made contributions to her school and community through participation in chorus, Girl Scouts, and basketball, and volunteered her time with younger children for a Veterans Day celebration. Sam was employed at Berry Patch Farms for 3 years. Next year, Sam plans to attend the University of North Carolina at Pembroke to major in early childhood education. Congratulations, Sam. ...2021 graduate, Aiden Heaney. This one's ours, Air. Aiden is the daughter of Aaron and Teresa Heaney. Aiden has made contributions to her school and community through participation in musical and theatrical productions, as a member of the National Honor Society, her class secretary, in all-county band and choirs, and in area all-state and conference all-state choir, on the Masterminds and Scholastic Challenge teams, as a member of St. Patrick's Church, in the American Legion Oratorical Competitions, the New York State Summer School of the Arts, and in productions with the Olean Theater Workshop, the Town Theater of Short Tract, the Valley Theater, and the Angelica Players. Aiden receives the Valedictorian for the Class of 2021 Award, the John E. Warner Memorial Award, a Theater Arts Award, a President's Award for Outstanding Academic Excellence, an Allegheny County National Honor Society Scholarship, the Belfast Teachers Memorial Scholarship, a Big 30 Academic Scholarship, the John W. Hasper Memorial Scholarship, a Lions Club Scholarship, a New York State Scholarship of Academic Excellence, the SUNY Fredonia Honors Award, the SUNY Fredonia President's Awards for Excellence, the Belfast Historical Society Scholarship, an Olean Theater Workshop Scholarship, and a Belva Waite Scholarship. Next year, Aiden plans to attend SUNY Fredonia in the BFA Acting Program. Congratulations, Aiden.
...2021 graduate, Isaac Hall. Isaac is the son of Steve and Crystal Hall and the grandson of Judy Hall. Isaac has made contributions to his school and community through his love of World War II and John Deere tractors. Isaac receives a Triple C Award. Next year, Isaac plans to attend Alfred State College, majoring in heavy equipment, truck, and diesel technician. Congratulations, Isaac. ...2021 graduate, Christian Lingenfelter. Christian is the son of Bob and Tina Lingenfelter. Christian has made contributions to his high school and community in numerous musical and theatrical productions as class treasurer, as a member of the National Honor Society and treasurer of National Honor Society, as a member of the Masterminds and Scholastic Challenge teams. Christian has completed a two-year course of study in the Project Lead the Way pre-engineering program at the Belmont Career and Technical Center, where he managed to earn a spot in the National Technical Honor Society for students maintaining an average of 94% or higher. And he was also the treasurer of NTHS. He was one of 23 students out of approximately 200 attending the Belmont CTE Center and the only Belfast student to receive this award. Christian receives a Theater Arts Award, a President's Awards for Outstanding Academic Excellence, a New York State Scholarship of Academic Excellence, and a Belleville Weight Scholarship. Next year, Christian plans to attend the University at Buffalo, majoring in aerospace and mechanical engineering. Congratulations, Christian. Graduate Christian Lopez. Christian is the son of Christopher Whitcomb and James Zuber. Christian has made contributions to his school and community through to participation on the soccer, basketball, and track teams. As a member and secretary of student council, where he has volunteered his time at the Snack Shack and of food giveaways, in several theatrical productions, and is a member of the National Honor Society. Christian receives a Theater Arts Award, a President's Awards for Outstanding Academic Excellence.
A Marie Miller Gleason Scholarship, the Allegheny County Pomona Grange 45 Perseverance Award, the Belfast Area Betterment Association Diet Chamberlain Scholarship, and a Lois M. Lilly Memorial Scholarship. Next year, Christian plans to attend SUNY Brockport, majoring in graphic design. Congratulations, Christian.
Money 21 graduate Lily Mahan. Lily is the daughter of Mark and Brandy Mahan. Lily has made contributions to her school and community through participation. Lily has been involved in a number of theatrical productions and is a member of the student council, where she has volunteered her time at the Snack Shack. She has been a part of the yearbook publication staff and has volunteered at PTO-sponsored events. Lily receives a Theater Arts Award, Belleville Weight Scholarship. Next year, Lily plans to attend Jamestown Community College for one semester before transferring to SUNY Geneseo, where she will double major in adolescent education in biology and individuals with disabilities. Congratulations, Lily.
Graduate Addison Mail. Addie is the daughter of Ken and Christina Mail. Addie has made contributions to her school and community through participation on the soccer, cheerleading, and softball teams, as a member of the National Honor Society, and in a number of musical and theatrical productions. Addie has completed a 2-year course of study in cosmetology at the Belmont Career and Technical Center. Addie receives a Theater Arts Award and an Amy Schaefer Garish Memorial Scholarship. Next year, Addie plans to attend Jamestown Community College, where she will pursue a nursing major. Congratulations, Addie. ...2021 graduate, Kelsey Morton. Kelsey is the daughter of Aaron and Jennifer Morton. Kelsey has made contributions to her school and community through participation on the soccer and softball teams, as a member of the National Honor Society, in all county band festivals, and through 4-H and FFA. Kelsey has volunteered her time at the SPCA and has been employed at ACES. Kelsey receives a President's Award for Outstanding Academic Excellence, the Esther Kuhn Thomas Scholarship, the Hasper and Dye 2-Year Future Award, and a Belva Waite Scholarship. Next year, Kelsey plans to attend SUNY Cobleskill, majoring in animal science. Congratulations, Kelsey. ...2021 graduate, Colin Preston. Colin is the son of Brian and Amanda Preston. Colin has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the soccer, basketball, and baseball teams, and as a volunteer with the boys' modified soccer team. Next year, Colin plans to attend Alfred State College, majoring in sports management. Congratulations, Colin. ...2021 graduate, Chase Sadler. Chase is the grandson of Sandra Sadler and the son of the late Donnie Joe Sadler. Chase has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the soccer team. Next year, Chase plans to continue his employment at Letchworth State Park with plans to become a ranger. Congratulations, Chase.
...2021 graduate, Camden Smith. Camden is the son of Lacey Fuller and Matthew Smith. Camden has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the basketball team and at the Belmont Career and Technical Center, where he has completed a 2-year course of study in the Project Lead the Way pre-engineering program. Next year, Camden plans to attend SUNY Cobleskill, majoring in agricultural business management. Congratulations, Camden. ...2021 graduate, Stephen Struckman. Stephen is the son of J.D. and Cindy Struckman. Stephen has made contributions to his school and community through participation on the soccer, basketball, and baseball teams, as a member of the National Honor Society, on the Masterminds and Scholastic Challenge teams, in numerous musical and theatrical productions, and in various all-county and area all-state ensembles for both vocal and instrumental music. Stephen receives the Ashland University Archer Success Grant, the Ashland University Director Scholarship, the Ashland University Music Minor Scholarship, the Deputy Sheriff Scholarship, a Theater Arts Award, a President's Award for Outstanding Academic Excellence, and an Allegheny County School Music Association Scholarship. Next year, Stephen plans to attend Ashland University, majoring in journalism and digital media with a music minor. Congratulations, Stephen. '20-'21 graduate Emma Sullivan. Emma is the daughter of Mark and Amy Sullivan. Emma has made contributions to her school and community through participation on the soccer, basketball, and softball teams, as a member and president of the National Honor Society, as class president, in numerous musical and theatrical productions, and has volunteered her time for the Belfast Children's Christmas Fund and at St. Patrick's Church. Emma has been selected to attend numerous all-county, area all-state, conference all-state, and all-eastern choirs. Emma has completed the New Visions Health Program at the Belmont Career and Technical Center and is employed at Cuba Memorial Hospital. Emma receives a salutatorian for the class of 2021, a President's Award for Outstanding Academic Excellence, an Allegheny County National Honor Society Scholarship, the Belfast PTO Scholarship, the Belfast Teachers Association Scholarship, an Amy Schaefer Garish Memorial Scholarship, the Nazareth College Dean Scholarship, the Nazareth Grit Grant, a Theater Arts Award, a Belfast Area Betterment Association Phil Rice Scholarship, a New York State Scholarship of Academic Excellence, a Belville Waite Scholarship, and the Paul Vienna Memorial Scholarship. Next year, Emma plans to attend Nazareth College, majoring in occupational therapy with a music minor. Congratulations, Emma. '20-'21 graduate David Tanney. David is the son of Lisa Snyder and Nicholas Tanney. David has completed a 2-year course of study in collision repair at the Belmont Career and Technical Center. Next year, David plans to seek employment. Congratulations, David.
'20-'21 graduate Damon Truesdell. Damon is the son of Lee and Jillian Truesdell. Next year, Damon plans to seek employment before continuing his education. Congratulations, Damon. '20-'21 graduate Sierra Wallace. Sierra is the daughter of Kevin and Amanda Wallace. Sierra has made contributions to her school and community through participation on the soccer and basketball teams as class vice president and as a member of the National Honor Society. Sierra receives a President's Award for Outstanding Academic Excellence, an Allegheny County National Honor Society Scholarship, a UNG in-state tuition equivalent scholarship, an Amy Schaefer Garish Memorial Scholarship, and the Monica Arnold Scholarship. Next year, Sierra plans to attend the University of North Georgia, majoring in biology with a focus in physician's assistant. Congratulations, Sierra. ...2021 graduate, Colin Weaver. Colin is the son of Dave and Sheila Weaver. Colin has completed a 2-year course of study in carpentry and construction at the Belmont Career and Technical Center. Next year, Colin plans to further his education in the field of heavy equipment operations. Congratulations, Colin. Class of 2021 has been awarded a total of $297,275 to use for their future educational endeavors. Congratulations to the class of 2021.
Will the graduates please rise? Ladies and gentlemen, by the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the State of New York, I hereby certify that these young adults have completed all the requirements for the diplomas that they have received, and it is with great pleasure that I present to you the Belfast Central School Class of 2021.
Your way and the vibe is feeling stronger. What's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond, and that bond will never be broken. The love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first, then the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn, and that line is what we reach. So remember me when I'm gone.
talk about family when family's all that we got. Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you